It certainly does. So Amazon has earnings post-market today, of course, one of the most highly anticipated earnings reports we'll look at. And one of the headwinds I saw actually going into earnings is Amazon made a huge investment into free one-day delivery to compete with its big box competitors like Walmart, Target. And people really love to get stuff free and they love to get stuff fast. And I think that's a huge reason people tweet about Amazon, because they love that everything's delivered on time. They love the efficiency of Amazon. I love the fact that it's free delivery. I mean, free is always relative because nothing is free. But Andy, I'm really curious to see what your data says about customers that expect free delivery, because I personally am also very passionate about it.
Yeah, it's unbelievable when you look at it. And one of the things we like to do at Likefolio is look at these kind of macro trends in consumer behavior and not just at the company level. And so when we look at the way consumers think about delivery, the expectation that that delivery be free is one of the most compelling charts that we've seen. In other words, you know, for a while there, it was nice to have, but somewhere around 2017, the acceleration in terms of consumers expecting and demanding the delivery of their products to be free absolutely accelerated at a phenomenal pace, and it's not slowing down anytime soon. And so for Amazon, they're in a decent position to take advantage of that. Like Jenny said, they've invested a lot in being able to provide free delivery. It does come with a caveat, though, and that is you have to be a member of Amazon's Prime, which I think is something like $120 per year. The kind of other side of the coin for Amazon, and the reason that, you know, longer term we're a little more skeptical on Amazon's ability to continue to deliver perfection, is that they actually have competent competition now. Walmart and Target are now able to deliver items for free with no membership fee. And so, you know, the competition is definitely heating up. The consumers have their demands in mind in terms of free delivery, and we've got a long way to go to figure out who's going to come out on top. It's been Amazon for 20 years. I don't know about the next 10.
Yeah, Andy, it's really shocking that Jenny likes stuff delivered for free, being the millennial that she is. But besides that, as far as your consumer's data shows on this free delivery, and you see it rolling over just a little bit at the top, but e-commerce sales are still only about, what, a 12% portion of what of consumer spending. So that chart that you guys have probably or most likely will continue to move higher as people expect it from not only Amazon, Walmart, Target, and others. Best Buy just added free shipping for the holiday season. It's going to continue to move higher as e-commerce sales continue to take away a chunk of overall retail sales.
Absolutely right. And I think the other kind of compelling stat that we saw when we dug into sort of the delivery movement was the way that consumers expect free delivery is one thing, but they also have high expectations in terms of the speed of the delivery. And so for that, what we looked at, the green line is the number of people that are demanding delivery be in 2 days or less. And so you think, wow, that's up and to the right, it looks really good, but what's going on at the end of the chart? And in order to understand why the expectation for 2 day delivery dips at the end of that chart, you have to look at the other line on there, the blue line, which is people who expect 1 day or same day delivery actually starting to eat into that. And so consumer preferences for delivery are that it be free and that it be very fast. And when they talk about fast, they're actually talking about same day or 1 day delivery. It's a whole new world. And we actually think that Walmart and Target and some of these other competitors of Amazon may be better positioned to actually deliver on that consumer demand going to the future, because they already have distribution centers all over the cities and towns across America.
And Andy, you bring up a really good point, because as of, I think, the last 6 months, I started using Walmart because I don't have to pay that $120 yearly fee. And I think my things get delivered faster. It's like you order in the morning and they're delivered by the end of the day. It's truly wild. And it, I mean, like, every time I'm like thrilled about it, and I'm probably the complete Target consumer. So.
But we don't have Walmarts by us here in the city.
It doesn't even matter. I mean, I'm telling you, the delivery speed is absolutely amazing. And okay, that's just reflected definitely on social media this morning. So our first tweet is from Trader Status, who says, Amazon, if this doesn't completely destroy and blow out earnings, it will be down huge, unfortunately. So this is kind of what we talked about earlier in the show. It seems like earnings are super, super all over the place this quarter. If you don't have a blowout quarter, you do get smacked.
Well, I look at the comparables from last year, this quarter, after their Amazon Prime Day, the release of the new products. Stock fell, it was at basically the same levels that the stock's trading now, fell $140 the day after earnings, after they reported. But 7 days later, it's right back to that level where it was pre-earning. So it does have that ability to move more than the one standard deviation that the option market price is in. But at the same time, maybe it recovers if it goes either way, either higher or lower.
Right, because it doesn't seem like it's fair as well to bet against Amazon. It always seems to kind of surprise us. But our next tweet is from Robert Durant, who says, with Facebook and Alphabet both ripping, Amazon should be in the 1800s before earnings and primed for a mega rip over 1900s. So, Andy, like you mentioned, I mean, there's a lot of headwinds going into this earnings report, and clearly they're not even at the 1800s right now. So could you possibly have a more bearish hint going into this report?
The way we're looking at it, it's very similar to what we talked about with Tesla yesterday. I think that their quarter could be very good. We see 30% year-over-year purchase intent mentions for this quarter, which includes that Prime Day that Tom was talking about. Very important. I think they had a fantastic Prime Day. So I think they're going to report a really nice quarter. You could see the stock pop, and it's one of those long term, I'm starting to see yellow flags around this company. And so I think it may be an opportunity if we do get that pop. To kind of fade the move like Tom's talking about. For Amazon, it's a great company. It is priced to perfection for a reason because they've delivered perfection for about 20 years. But how long can that keep up now that they actually have competent competition in retail? It's getting tougher for them. And consumers, what consumers are demanding is only growing in terms of intensity.
Hey, quick kind of final thoughts here, Andy. When you're talking about consumer purchase intent growth, obviously now Amazon's as much a cloud company as it is a retail e-commerce website. Is that factoring in any AWS or is that just on the retail front?
Pretty much just on the retail front. We do track people talking about, you know, starting an Amazon cloud account, but we don't have really great visibility into how much they're spending. And so when we talk about this, we are talking mostly about the retail side of their business.
Good to clear that up. Thanks, Andy. And then the last thing, too, we always talk about second and third order effects. This race to this 1 and 2 day shipping, we know it's putting pressure on Amazon and Walmart and Target's margins, but doesn't this put even more pressure on companies like Macy's and some of these mall companies than it does on something like Amazon?
Yeah, I mean, if you don't have the technology or the distribution network to get this done, the entire consumer movement is a headwind against you. Less and less people are going to the mall, and more people want free, fast delivery. And those companies that have 40,000 square feet at the end of a mall are sitting there kind of stuck without much to do. They've got to make some big bets. I think we'll start seeing that in 2020. They're going to have to do something pretty outrageous to get the consumer on their side again.